Let me one with a testimony of what the goodness of the goodness of the Lord. Amen. God bless you, Sister Wayne. God bless. Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because the word tells us to enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. Hallelujah. The word also says that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. So hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, I have so many testimonies this morning. Well, to me, it's like the enemy attacked me yesterday. I had company all weekend. I decided to do the spring cleaning after they left, washing clothes and changing his curtains and all of this stuff. And then all of a sudden, I was walking around like this. And I'm telling you, I was in pain. My husband said today, you're going to the doctor tomorrow. I decided to come to Dr. Jesus. My body was hurting so bad that I really couldn't do anything to my hair, but I'm like, I got a lot of scars. I'm going to wrap them around. I'm going to go and receive from the Lord. We've sang these songs. We've read these words. I decided to come. And praise the Lord. I talked about the run all over this church. I do not care what others think. I care what God thinks about me. He's invested a lot in me. And so the devil can't hold me, keep me back down, make me bound. Whatever he tried to do, I just praise it off of me. Thank the Lord. I just want to share a testimony. On this week, we went to the prison. We took some of the kids, and they got to see their folks. So we got to see Cynthia, and Cynthia says she can't wait to be home, come home. And I just had such a good time with those children. And the Lord just keeps reminding me that this is what it's about. We have to invest in these children. We've got to deposit the word of God in these children so that they'll have something to stand on, you know, to help them to make the choices. And so my job is to be a chaperone to the children. We take a couple of band children. And the hardest part is when we get ready to leave. And they have to leave their moms or grandmothers or aunts or whatever they want to see. But to have the love of God in you and let it shine to bless them and carry them and love on them is such a joy. But this is my testimony. I came to Dr. Jesus and my hip is not hurting. Hallelujah. Devil, you a lie. As I was getting ready, bathing, I was praising the Lord, giving him all the praise and all the glory. And so sometimes we're going to have to press on past the pain and stuff that the enemy tries to bring. I might have overdid it. My husband said, you don't know how to do a little and don't know how to stop. But anyway, I thank God for Jesus. I learned a little song that I wanted to teach the children. Yes, Jesus loved me, but I learned it in sign language. They have a Christian clown that comes, and he teaches about Jesus. Several children receive the Lord and that spirit filled. You know, the mothers, the inmates. So we have a good time in the Lord when we go down, so it was a joy. But the one song that I learned, yes, Jesus loves me. And I'm going to... Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus. And I had a question. I said, I have a problem with this. You know, you got to put your finger here. But that's because of what Jesus took. The nails in his hand. So it's yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus
loves me, for the Bible tells me so. Yes, it says, little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me.
This is going to help someone here
Some of us are dealing with some serious situations in our family lives and our health. But oftentimes what happens when we begin to deal with serious and tragic situations in our life, sometimes, how do you know that when you're sick, where do we normally go? To the doctor, to the hospital. But how many of you know that when we're sick spiritually, a lot of times spiritual things are a manifestation of things that happen in the natural. But how many of you know when you're sick in your life, in your family, in your finances, your health, how many of you know that the best place to be is at the church hospital? But oftentimes when we become so sick and distraught, this is the very place we avoid. But God was just beginning to show me in my life that it's so important for us to begin to connect with the ministry. And as I began to do that, and there were times when I didn't feel good, when I had to play the drums, there were times when I didn't feel like coming, but I came anyway. Why is that important? Let me just tell you this. God has always provided for me and my family, no matter what. And I just thank God for recently He provided. We've been in business probably within the last year. God has really blessed our business and our personal endeavors, where actually through the finances, through my business, I was able to take care of partly with my household. You know, Tia works too. But God, we never missed a bill. We never were late. We never was hungry. God always provided. But my wife did have a request. She said, Derek, the one thing, you're really doing good. We're doing good in the business. But she said, I would like this money to be the extra money, not the main money. And so I said, hey, I don't have a problem with that. So God provided an opportunity where I was able to get a job. And my mom had someone that she knew. And I'm going to show you how God works. I knew people who were in this particular position 6 to 9 months. It was a 2-year program that you had to go to to get to this position, but from favor, I should say, my mom was able to make a phone call to the person who was over everything. And how do you know that when you have a good name, it goes a long way? And the lady who was over everything, who called the shots, my mom actually trained over 20 years ago. And as I began to sit down with her, she said, if it wasn't for your mom, she said, I would have quit this job a long time ago. I was frustrated. I didn't think I could do the job. And so, in other words, she made it happen where I didn't have to go through the 6 months, the 9 months, the 2-year deal. She brought me in. And then on top of that, she called the shots on the pay. And I was like, hallelujah. And so when I say, what am I saying is, I believe that came from just being faithful to God. Faithful to call, even when I didn't feel like coming on Wednesday, when I didn't want to come on Sunday, when I didn't want to come any other day. When God had something for me to do, I said, God, I don't know how you're going to do it, but I trust that you will do it. Oftentimes we want God to show up first, then I'll do it. But God said, no, what you need to do first, trust me and have faith. I mean, you know, Hebrews 11 said, without faith is what? It's impossible to please God. So if we always know how it's going to happen, if we always know how it's going to come, that's really not faith. But God does require us to trust Him even when we don't understand or we don't know the outcome. And I guarantee you, as you begin to trust the Lord, as you begin to believe, and as you begin to put your faith in Him, He will begin to open up the doors to you that you would never think is possible. I mean, you know that one day of favor with God is better than 1,000 years of labor. And I'm a living testimony to that. So my encouragement to you is, no matter where you are in your life, in your family situation, your finances, your health, begin to submit to God. Begin to say, God, what would you have me to do? And let me say this. I'm going to put a disclaimer and a guarantee that as you begin to do that, God will begin to open up the doors of heaven, and He will pour out so much to you that you won't have room enough to receive. My question to you is, will you believe? God bless you.
That's all the testimonies, so this is one. And I'll know everything. God bless.